Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to make this lower third and this lower third. And bring it into ecamm. Okay, so first off, we want to open up a new Keynote document. So we're going to choose a theme of just basic white. Okay, so now we've got our basic white set up. We're going to delete all of these and we're going to go into document, slide size, custom slide size. And here we're going to add 3840 by 800. Now, this is quite a large file size, but this is so that you can also use these animations if you're doing a 4K video. Okay, so now we're just going to kind of get it set up a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab this line here and we're going to push this away. And then we're going to go to view and we're going to go show object list. And we're also then going to go to view and click show rulers. This is basically just so we have what we want in front of us. Now we're going to add a guide. We're going to do this two lines in. So as you can see here, we're two lines in on this. So we're 200 in, as you can see here. And this is basically just because we're not really going to go above this. Okay, so now we're going to start building out the basic shape. So we're going to insert a shape of a rounded rectangle. Going to bring it up here and put it up against this line. And I'm going to hold down shift while dragging this out. And then while still holding on shift, I'm going to let go. And now let go of shift. This basically just means that we don't kind of knock it at the end. And now we're going to resize this. So we're going to go into arrange and constrain proportions. This would just keep it as a square. And now let's go 300 by 300. Now this is our basic shape. Now we're going to click Command C and Command V to copy and paste it. And then we're going to click constrain proportions again to turn it off. And we're just going to drag this end one. Now this is really long, so we're now going to basically judge how big we want it. So we're going to insert a text box, and in that we're going to write our name. Now we're going to click off it and click back on, basically so that we don't have to select a certain amount of text. We're going to go into text. We want to pick our font. And align to the left and bring it up. Now this is about how big I want mine, and there's a lot of area here where I don't actually need this bar to be, so I'm going to drag this in so it comes to about here, and that's where I want mine. So basically with these sizes, just get the text to how big you want it, and different fonts will be different sizes, and basically just drag the rectangle to fit. Okay, so I know mine is going to be a white background, so I'm going to get my text and I'm going to select one of our pre-done font colors. So I'm just going to use one of our colors. This is our branding color. And now I'm kind of done with my text. So we're now going to insert a shape of a rectangle and we're going to hold down shift and just drag it out. This doesn't really matter. It's just going to be a ruler, so it doesn't matter if it's perfectly straight or not. And then we're going to go into arrange. Angle, and we're going to go for 75 degrees. Now, this is kind of our ruler. We're also going to make this a bright color so it stands out and doesn't mix in with any of the rest of it. And now we're going to drag it to the end, and I'm going to do Command, Shift, and Full Stop to zoom in. So now we're going to drag from the ruler, and this is going to make a guide. So we're going to put one where it aligns at the top, and one where it aligns at the bottom. And we're also going to do this from the top down, so that we have the bottom of our rectangle. Now we're going to scroll across and drag this over and do the same on this side. And then finally, we're going to do it here. Okay, and now we're going to zoom out with Command Shift and the comma. And let's just remove this green box. Okay, and now you might be looking at this like, that looks a little bit complex, but actually these are just our guides to go off of. So we're going to zoom in over here with Command Shift Full Stop, and we're gonna select our rectangle, right click, and say make editable. And now we're gonna delete all of these except from these two squares. Okay, and now I'm gonna zoom in even more with Command Shift and Full Stop to get it as precise as I can, and we're just going to put this top one in this corner and go to the bottom one and put it in this corner. And now I'm basically going to scroll over to the other side and do the exact same thing. Okay, so for me, my text isn't really where I want it, but for now, this doesn't matter. I'll change that after. Okay, and I kind of want to get more room out of this and don't want it to be a perfect square. So I'm going to drag this out to here and I'm going to do the same as I did on the other rectangle. And there we go. So now let's quickly check these line up. Yep. Okay, so now we don't really need these guides here anymore. So we're going to go up to View, Guides, and Hide Guides. Now I'm going to bring these together a bit, and it doesn't really matter about the amount of gap that there is between them. This is really just up to you. I'm gonna say I want that much of a gap, and let's bring the text a bit closer. And there we go, that's kind of our basic shape of it. And now we can basically just edit them. So I'm gonna click on this. So I'm gonna click on this one, go over here into Format, Style, and then Fill. I want to change this to an Advanced Gradient Fill. I want to select this one and do one of our pre-made colors. I'd recommend using two similar colors or just colors that work together, but this is basically just up to you and how you want it. Now I'm going to move my colors over to here because I don't need them for now. And I think I want more of this darker blue, so I'm gonna drag this to a line where it goes to, and you can see here that as I move this, it kind of changes where they mix. So if I brought these both into the middle, we'd have a very solid line, and the more I bring it out, the more I kind of long out how far away they are. So I want more of this dark blue, so I'm gonna bring this over into the lighter blues area. Great, now we're gonna do the same on this rectangle, so Advanced Gradient Fill. Now this is kind of automatically done the same as that one, but for this, I want to select this one, and I'm gonna do a white, and I'm gonna select this one, and I'm gonna do slightly gray, and I'm gonna bring this more to the middle. Now, I actually prefer the dark to be on the bottom as it kind of keeps it similar between them, so I'm gonna click this to reverse the direction. And now we've basically got the blue going into the lighter blue and the darker white going into the lighter white. You may not be able to see this that well at the moment, but once we remove the background and it's transparent, you'll be able to see it well. Okay, so now we're gonna add a logo onto this rectangle here. For me, I'm gonna grab our cartoon of Adrian, and now that that's been brought in, I wanna bring it into here and kind of just put it to where I think is center. Okay, so I think that works quite well. Now, if you don't have a logo like this and you have one that is just a solid picture, then I'm just gonna copy and paste this so I can show you. But say if, for example, we have a wood background, and if we wanted that to be this, then I could bring it over and put it on top of it and kind of just select them both. And then we're going to go into Format, Image, and Mask with Selection. And now when we come out of it, this is basically cut the picture to this shape. And then you can right click on it and go onto Edit Mask and kind of just move around how you want this. So that is something that you could do. But for me, I want it to be this logo. Okay, and now for the design of it, that's pretty much it. So I'm going to click so I've got nothing selected. And then when I go into Format, it should say about my slide. And I'm gonna go into where it says color fill and click no fill. And now you can see this all a lot better. Okay, so now we're gonna animate it. So the animations of this aren't actually that complex. So we're going to click on the shape and the face. And then we're gonna go into arrange and group. And then we're gonna do the same on this shape and the text, arrange, group. So now these basically just mean that these work together. So the first thing we want to come in is this face. So let's select it, go to animate, and add a build-in effect. For this, we're just going to do a move in. We're going to take off the bounce and do it from bottom to top. So this will look like this. I'm going to speed it up a bit to 0.6 seconds, basically just to make it a little bit faster. And that's our move in. Now we're going to select on our name, add a build-in effect, and we're going to add a wipe. So we want ours from left. I'm gonna again speed this up. That works well for me at 0.6 seconds. And now what we're gonna do is over in the build order, I'm just gonna pick this up by clicking on it and holding and drag it up so that this blue line appears and let go. And now when I click on it, it should say after build one, and I'm gonna add a delay of 0.3 seconds. So now when we preview this, it will look like this. And I think that works. You can change around these speeds, see what you like with it. And now while I'm still selected on the name, I'm gonna go to build out and add a build out effect of wipe. We're gonna do it from right and this was on 0.6, so we're gonna do it the same just so that it's consistent, and we're gonna drag it up again. For this, you can't select it to be with build two because one is wiping in and one's wiping out and they don't work together. But for this, we're gonna do after build two and we're gonna add a delay of 3.5 seconds. So that now when we preview it, it will stay here for about 3.5 seconds. And now I'm gonna select on the logo, build out, add an effect, move out. We're gonna do top to bottom, take off the bounce, take this down to 0.6 again so it's consistent, move this up to it, and 0.3 delay. This is just again so it's the same speeds as how it came in. So now when it comes up, you can talk about it, you can introduce yourself, and then when it's ready, it'll move out and go away. Okay, so that's pretty much it for what we're gonna do in Keynote. So now you can name it. So we're just gonna call ours lower third, and we're gonna save it to Keynote, and I'm gonna do Command S to make sure it's saved. And we're gonna do File, Export to Movie, and yours may show up like this. So we're gonna change, go to next slide to 0, and next build, 0. Now, if yours shows up like this, don't just be like, oh, it's in 1080p, that's great, that's all I need. What we actually want to do is go into custom. For me, it's picked it up. If it's not, then you just want to put these numbers back in again. All of our videos are done in 25 frames per second because we're in the UK. For you in America, you're probably in 30 frames per second. So I'd recommend if you're doing it in 25 to put this to 50, and if you're doing it in 30 to put this to 60. So I'm gonna leave mine on 50. And now you want Apple ProRes 4444 and make sure export with transparent backgrounds is on. And now we're gonna click next. Where, let's do it to desktop and export. Great, so that's brought it in, and now let's bring it into ecamm. Okay, so we're gonna make a new scene and we're just gonna do lower third. And now, quite simply, we can drag this on from our desktop. And bring it down. Now what you'll notice is that here it's actually left a piece. So what you're gonna need to set is to when done, hide. So that now when this finishes, it will disappear. And I'm gonna bring mine down to the bottom so that when I'm talking, I can come on and be like, hi, I'm Owen. And basically just talk about that. Maybe where I work, that kind of thing, and then it's gone by the time I finished. Now, if you want to change things with this and how it goes, so for example, I might think this is a bit small and a bit too high, so you can go back into your Keynote, basically just select these and bring them down a bit, and you can do the exact same thing with exporting, so export to movie, set this to 0, set this to 0, these have already got our things, Apple ProRes 444 with transparent backgrounds, and let's call it our lower third version 2. And now we're gonna save it again to desktop. And now that's saved to our desktop, so we can open ecamm back up again, go into our overlays, and let's just hide this one and move this one in. And that's a little bit better, but remember, we do need to add it so it hides. And there we go, that's our lower third. You can add things to this, like for example, if I wanted to, if I wanted to put where I worked, I could add another shape. So maybe I just want to insert shape, rounded rectangle. Let's make this our branding. I'll add the same gradient as I did for the logo and make these look the same. And I'm just going to bring this down, bring it across here, and there we go. And now I'm going to copy and paste my text. Let's take it out of this group and bring it to the top. And we can just put, and you can just put where you work. So this could be if you work for a bigger company and you want to represent them, then you can put in where you work. I'm gonna change mine to white and just bring it down so it's smaller. I'm also gonna change the font to a thinner font. And I'm just gonna put it below, drag this over and align the text. Okay, so that's kind of all I need to add for this. I'm then going to select these, group them together, and move them underneath everything, so they kind of just sit out like this. Okay, so now I'm gonna animate this. So I'm just going to copy it and paste it and drop that in. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this up so it sits behind. I'm going to add a build in, which is just to appear. So that will just come in and then add an action to move. Now let's grab this here to change where it moves to and bring it straight down. We've kept the other one down here to kind of try and line it up a bit better. So we'll zoom in and try and get it kind of as close as we can. Now we know we liked it there. Now let's just click off it and select the one that's sitting at the bottom and delete that. And we're gonna put this in here. So now we're gonna bring this down to 0.6. So everything's kind of moving at the same speeds. And we're gonna take this delay down by about 75 seconds. So now let's preview it. Okay, and I'm gonna select it again, add another action to move again. And now I'm gonna put it back. So let's just line up this square with where this line ends. This doesn't really matter if it's perfect, just kind of try and keep it so it's going straight back up. And now this kind of thing, you can see in my build order, these are all kind of muddled together. So I can rename these by double clicking on them. So logo, name, and let's call this work. So now this has split them all up to what they are and I can now actually see what they are. Now let's put this in after, add a delay. So this is kind of where we want our delay to be. So I think, so we had 2.75 and then I'm gonna take this down and now on work, I'm gonna add a build out effect to add effect, disappear. And I'm gonna do that after this move. Okay, so now when we preview it, it will look a bit more like this. And now what you saw there was that work was below the wipe of name. So if we set this to go above it and that to be after, then when we watch it back again, it'll now be gone. And okay, we like that. So now we're gonna do the same of file, export to movie, set these to 0. The rest is all kept from last time. And now I'm gonna do with work. That's exported. Now let's go into ecamm and drag this in. Remember to add when finished hide. And then let's hide the last one. So that now when we play it, it just kind of looks a little bit better. And there we go. So that's how you make a lower third like that. We'll also give you access to the Keynote file. So you can basically just edit these. So you can go into here and add a logo into here and you can select on there and put in your name. And of course as well, you can go into here and put in your company. Or if you don't want that little bit to pop up on the bottom, you can quite simply just click to get rid of it. I'd also recommend if you've got a longer name, so if your name is longer, then you want to drag this out and that doesn't fit on here. So what I'd now recommend you do is insert that rectangle and go into arrange, add 75 degrees to it, style, put it as a bright green or a bright blue, and then you can go into view, guides, show guides, and now these have all moved, but I can bring these down, and then you can just add your guides where you want them, and do the exact same as what we did before. So we're just gonna drag these, to that one, and this to that one. And now it's all set. So then when we go up and hide our guides, this is now the same, just longer. So we're actually gonna leave this rectangle in the template. So I'd recommend if you want to use it, basically just bring this down and move it along. Okay, so that's how you use this, then that's how you edit this after. You can basically just have a play around with this. We'd love to see what you came up with, so make sure to post in the group, and I hope this was helpful.